What is up, YouTube? It's your boy JD Owens, and I'm back with another Madden video. I know it's been a while, we've just been through testing with school, and I'm out for the summer now. So, more videos, more of them. And this is the lineup. Nothing really, well, you just have. I picked up Amon Green and Adrian Peterson. These dudes were hustlers. Since Amon Green get tired, I'm gonna keep on hitting you with Adrian Peterson. T.Y. Hilton. I had to with the chemistry. I hate chemistry this year. I got Tom Hendry back. Tom Hendry is the best left outside linebacker that I used all year. So we got him back. Howie Long was a beast. Yeah. Picked up this Logan Ryan. This Logan Ryan. I had his 91 overall. It's hard. And that car was good for me. So. And his stats look pretty good, so. Got him in the slide, David Emerson, Eli Apple, Sean Taylor. I'm just sending Sean Taylor on some blitzes. And I got a new kicker. I'm loving that. Go play. I haven't played in a while, so if I'm a little rusty, don't worry about it.
Charles and I settled here in the booth. Okay. This should be a fun one. Madden Ultimate Team matchup. As you get a look at some of the stars here of today's game, let's get right to it. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Fielded about a yard deep. A good safe pass there right off the bat.
That's almost a rhythm play. That's what we like to call it. Get them into rhythm early, something safe, something they're confident about, something they feel good. And once that's completed, then you just keep moving from there because the confidence elevates. Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude, but I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
Now he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. They'll run it here. This is James White. Just a 2-yard pickup, and that should necessitate a call for the punt team here on fourth down.
Norton played really good run defense when you're playing a 3-4. Those three guys up front, the nose tackle and the guys they call the defensive ends, they're usually big, big people because they're going to have to eat up a lot of blockers because it's usually 5-on-3. And when they do their job well, guys who play on the inside, those inside linebackers, they will just roam and hit.
They'll run for it. This is White. And he is going to lose yardage here. A surprising move here on the opening drive of the game. And the ball will go over on Downs on the short side of the field. Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit. Now McNair looking for a first down throw. He's got a man wide open. It's Herman Moore. And he gets into the end zone for the touchdown.
Like that.
Herman Moore, 29 yards. And his guys have taken a first quarter lead.
I think if you pulled defensive backs, they would say the corner route, take that out, make it illegal, because that is so hard to recognize and so hard to adjust, because your first move is to not get beat in the middle of the field, and that's how they move you first before they break off to the corner.
But then as a wide receiver, great job. It's tough to turn those upfield and go, but he did a great job with it there.
Really good balance, really good body control, and how about the end result? A touchdown.
So the Broncos coming out now. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they used the term complimentary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue.
That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end. Let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
He's going to let this one go deep. That's caught inside the 20.
Oh, my God.
It's
gosh.
A big play there
this
for the Broncos.
Nothing.
43 yards. Well, we know he's got the speed there. He needed the speed and the hands. A great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're...
And that is caught.
Oh,
touchdown,
my.
Denver. Odell Beckham, a 15-yard touchdown grab. And the Broncos are an extra point away from tying the football game. And partner, they found a gap there on the post pattern, and it was in the middle third of the field.
And that's really difficult to do, because ordinarily the safeties are back there to prevent that happening. But they found the opening and exploited it.
It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece.
This time I'm late.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Out comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is power, isn't it? When you scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gain, they can run that plan any down.
So the run moves the chains, and here we go on first down.
Let's go!
On first down, it's McNair. And he's got his man on the out route.
Get off.
And he finally goes down, but not before reaching the 21.
Coaches really don't care from what position they get this, but run after the catch ability, rack ability, is often the difference between winning and losing and changing field position.
Oh, he pulls over him. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
On 2nd down, McNair. Man open left side is Brown. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, does he? Rifles one, that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And the return just out across the 15 to the 16-yard line. And Denver getting set to take the field. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counter-punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got to a good rhythm.
Oh,
you see a little more bounce in and
is
out.
Is that Randy Moss
you
that
can see the sideline really get into the game.
Is
so
that Randy Moss?
You're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love
we'll
it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive. Here's White.
Yeah.
Across the 30 to the 31.
Yeah, I like
yard
my defense. My defense.
It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Now Brady throwing on second down. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. And he's certainly not a guy that drops that football very often.
Indeed, because that's a bit of a surprise. I know he's in the middle of some traffic and people, bodies all around him, but he usually has the focus to haul that one in.
Throwing is Brady on third down. He finds Beckham complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
I've got to make sure that I don't take Tom Brady's greatness for granted, that we make it routine. How about that throw right there?
Yeah.
Another great completion.
And you know one area where he honed his throwing? He was a catcher in high school. He was actually drafted by the Expos in 1995 in the 18th round.
Wow, that would have been something to see him behind the dish.
Think he gunned down a few guys?
Gunned down a few guys trying to steal second. That would have been fun to watch. Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. And he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers. They usually not as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
And here comes
Eli
play Allen. Number six on this drive.
You gotta do better than that. I mean, Eli Apple.
Now a toss play. This is White. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
One of the toughest things for an offensive lineman to learn is the ability to get in space and hit people who are moving targets. And linebackers are not easy ones to hit because they know how to move, juke, and make you miss. And that's exactly what he did on that play. A nice play for the defense.
2 minutes to play in a tightly contested first half. Back to FedEx Field following this short break.
Third and five, so they bring in an extra defensive back.
Expecting pass. And right side, Henry's got it. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. And no field goal try here from the red zone. Offense out there. They'll go for it on fourth. To throw, it's Brady. That's complete right around the
head.
It's a gain of 13 for number 13, and it gives him a first down.
Well, the field goal attempt is well in hand. They had that, but they decided to go for it anyway. Extreme confidence, it looks like.
Yeah, but I bet the defense is going to remember this one, right? They kind of rubbed their nose in it. They come out here in the eye. Now White. And he'll get in. Touchdown, Denver. James White, a 5-yard touchdown run. And the Broncos have taken the lead. Solid job up front, really just a solid job all the way around to get that one in.
That was well executed, wasn't it? Well blocked, well run. End result, 6 points.
Touchdown. So after the touchdown, Martin now on to kick this one away. Fairly short kick taken at the 14 here. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. And now back out comes the offense. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told them, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football, and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
On first and 10, McNair. This will be caught by Brown. That throw good for four. It's second down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Come on, let's go. From the gun, here's McNair. Got a man, it's Brown. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
And incomplete. He can't hang on. Would have been a nice catch. Instead, it brings up a fourth down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. Yep. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
They'll try and throw for it here. And able to find Green. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. The whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Now McNair looking for a first down throw. And almost intercepted. It would have been his second pick of the game. Instead, it'll be second down. Well, he just threw an interception last drive, nearly another pick.
And things aren't very even right now, are they? It's a little bit sloppy out there, isn't it? It's kind of different driving on those paved roads and those country roads that have those potholes in them, isn't it? Because that's the way this game's going right now. A lot of bouncity bounce to it.
You spent some time on some Tennessee country roads.
I certainly have. Plenty of family back there. God love them.
So here we go now. An extra defensive back in there on third and 10. McNair to throw. He's going to go up top again. Now a battle for the football. It's caught. It's a touchdown.
Let's go.
Carmen Moore.
Who said this ain't bad?
Seconds of the first half. And his guys are an extra point away from tying this thing up.
That's one of the better examples of clock management I've seen. Riddled it all the way down just about and still put the ball in the end zone.
Well, just a methodical drive and something really to take into the lockers here. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. And Denver getting set to take the field. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. All right, hang on. We'll jump over halftime. And we welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number three here. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This will be fielded at the six. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. And here now the offense heading back out more. There. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. Second down, McNair. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. It's a gain of four there, and it gives him a new set of downs.
He's a rookie, and you don't want to get hung up on the word potential, but when you see him make catches like that, you keep thinking to yourself, he's good now. He's got a chance to be great with plenty of work.
Here's McNair. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. It's a gain of 20 that time. And it'll give them the first down. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. Now a play fake here on first down. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And it's caught at the 6-yard line. They give him a gain of 38. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's, and that's exactly what they did there. A missed opportunity for an interception would have killed off a drive. They had a chance there to finish things off. Didn't get it done. I guess that's why a lot of those guys do not play offense.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. Call it a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal.
I have to laugh a little bit because he actually handed it off. I thought with the two touchdown passes he's thrown in this one already, he'd go ahead and fling and try and get a third one.
Yeah, now from this spot on third down, I think he'd probably throw it here.
Yeah, I don't think there's any question about it. They won't even send in a running play here, I don't believe. I think they go ahead and try and throw it for a touchdown. This is where it gets fun because this is a big decision coming up. Listen to the crowd. You can tell they've already made their decision. You know they want them to go for it. But the big decision does rest with the head coach. What will he decide to do?
They come out with one back and three tight ends. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he is into the end zone for a touchdown. A great play there. Punching it in from a yard away. And his guys are going to retake the lead. So they went for it from the one on fourth and goal, and they got it done.
Is this the new NFL?
This is the new NFL.
This is the updated NFL, and I like it. I know the quarterbacks across the league has spent the entire offseason and even during the season lobbying their coaches to go for it more on fourth down. Let's go get it. Because nowadays, you've got to score points to win games in the NFL. You can't just rely on your defense to hold them.
I think the quarterbacks want to eliminate field goals inside of 30 yards, probably.
Well, listen, they have enough confidence in themselves that they can call plays and make plays that they won't need those field goals inside the 30.
Down looking deep downfield. Oh, this is taken in, it's complete. And oh, so close as he takes it all the way to the 2-yard line. So the defense blitzed. A nice job picking that up.
That was
me. The pass.
I had you when he's there.
Was the quarterback in his center on that play? They saw the blitz, made the appropriate calls, got the line engaged because now they know there are going to be extra guys coming at the quarterback, so they got their assignment.
And he will take it in for a Bronco touchdown. James White, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Broncos are an extra point away from tying the football game. He's got it tied at 21. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. This one taken from the 7. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Now this offense ready to head back out there. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
And he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Man open left side is Brown. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line.
Well,
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. They'll run it now out of the gun. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a 2nd and 3.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball. But when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
Now McNair toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done.
If you're running out route, it's likely you're going to end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd down. Back now at FedEx Field. All even as we get ready to start the 4th. McNair looking left side, that's caught by Moore, and he gets this one all the way down inside the 15. So another catch for Herman Moore, and back in his day he was a volume receiver. He still is, I guess.
He had no doubt about it. What'd he have, over 100 catches 3 different times in the league? That's pretty impressive.
Still holds the franchise mark with 123 catches way back in 95. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a 1st and goal.
I thought guys that were over 30 weren't supposed to run the football this well in the National Football League. How about that veteran leadership? A big-time run combined with some nice blocking by his offensive line, showing that the ins and outs of being a veteran still has his place in this league. His odometer is not totally turned over yet. Got to give a lot of credit to the defensive front there. They held their ground. Pretty much stoned him on that play and ended up creating a lost yardage play.
Yeah, drop him from the 1 back to the 2. They'll need to get the play off quickly. And they're not going to get this one off in time. It'll be a delay. Even score late in the 4th. Let's see if the defense can play within themselves, not give up the big play and contain, and keep this knotted up. Out of the gun, it's McNair. That's caught at the 2. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. 6 yards on the pickup, and that is going to set up 3rd and goal. This defense hasn't let them in yet. They'll need to stiffen here. 3rd and goal from the 2. Time running out here on the play clock. Time for a break. We'll come back and see how it all shakes out after this. Stonewalled on second down. Now let's see what they can do on third and goal from the two. The play clock's running down. They'll try and pass back to Juszczyk. And he is into the end zone for a touchdown. Kyle Juszczyk taking it in from a yard out. And his guys are going to take the lead.
And there's the go-ahead touchdown. And so likely we'll kick an extra point. But to me, I'm looking forward. Special teams now with your kickoff. And then your defense, that's where the pressure shifts.
Yeah, because there's plenty of time left on that clock. Anytime you're over a minute in the NFL, there's a chance. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And Denver getting set to take the field. Hmm. Last time they were out, they scored. Still trailing here, though, so some
work.
But it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored the last time, they're not quite as worried about being down on the scoreboard because now their confidence is a little bit higher. They feel like they got something going, and they feel like they can attack again and put more points on the board.
Are you scoreboard watching if you're the offense, or are you just focused on this drive?
We wouldn't be telling the truth if we said that they didn't scoreboard watch. Everyone does it to some extent.
And got his man complete. Just right. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Well, we haven't been shortchanged on offense. Another fun play to watch there on the deep pass.
This game has the feel of, what, a turkey bowl, a Thanksgiving day. You know, when we get together this year, when the Davises and the Gardens get together, that's what our playbook's going to look like. Like they're drawing them up in the dirt, and so far it's working for both of them.
Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. He'll look to throw. And right side, Henry's got it. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
So here we go, a third down after the second down pass completion. They'll look to throw. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
For him to be that wide open and drop it, sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much, and your hands get shaky.
And yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch he should have made. Down seven, and they've got to go for it here on fourth down. Back to throw. And no, it's incomplete.
Let's go.
They had to go for it with such little time remaining. Just about all she wrote for this one. So out now comes the offense back onto the field. They have the lead, still a one possession game, but the defense got to stop. They've got the football now, just salted away, right?
Exactly. That's all the defense is counting on from their offense. They did their job in a.
Now the Broncos are going to take a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Looks like he'll throw here. He rifles complete, caught by Moore. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage. If he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get.
Oh, a ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. But he will not be able to bring it back. My goodness, what a bizarre ending. The kind of decision that could get a quarterback released before he gets back to the locker room. But fortunately for him and his crew, the ball game is over. And Charles, when you pull out a close game, the good thing about that is maybe next time you're in a nail biter in the fourth quarter, you have a little more confidence.
Yeah, you're talking about your memory muscles, right? When you win those close ones, you have that confident feeling that you can continue to do so every time you're in that position.
Well, that said, you would rather win by 60 points, or do you like the close ones
so
too?
Well, I think everyone would rather win by 60. It's comfortable. Everyone gets to play. But when you win those.
So happy. I'm just
playing. That's it, you guys. We are 3-0 in this league, so I'll bring you another video probably tomorrow. Well, see ya and peace. Well, hold on. Like, comment, subscribe, and peace.